This video was asked by a viewer to have more control when generating a video using the first and last frame. And this workflow makes it possible. I am using 4 frames uploaded as an image, and with the help of Alora by the Morphic team, it worked. The project Frame to Video by Morphic has released Alora, which can be used with the WAN 2.2 video model. This will not replace the first and last frame technique, but should make it better by giving us more control on the video. Let's understand the workflow. I have used 4 different images to generate this transition, from pencil sketch to manga style, and then it becomes a 3D style image, which then becomes a realistic person. You must be aware that the WAN 2.2 workflow contains 2 case samplers, the high and the low noise models. The models are on the left here. And this Torch compile is not in use. If you have the Triton installed, you can try using this to speed up the process. However, it may also result in an error. So, this is the WAN 2.2 FP8 model. And the links to the models are given above. These are the GGUF models. Download the smaller model based on your graphics memory. Below are the direct download links for the Q6 model, which worked on the smaller graphics card. These are the links to the FP8 files, and below is the direct download option for the model I am using right now. The attention model is set to Sage Attention. I made a simple installation video of Sage Attention, and the link will be shared in the description. You can select SDPA if you do not have Sage Attention installed. This is for block swap, and below is the Laura by the Morphic team. So, the high noise model goes to the first case sampler, and the output generated goes to the second case sampler, which is using the low noise model. Also, there is a Light X2 V-Laura, an accelerator with a low noise model. Increase this block swap node in case your model is larger than the graphics memory. This is for both the high and low noise models. Links to the LoRa are given above. These are the lightning accelerators. And this is the Light X2V I am using. The third is the high noise LoRa by the Morphic team. These are the text encoder nodes. And these are the older text encoder nodes. We can use this. Or you can use the newer nodes, have it connected to the text embeds in the case sampler, then it should work. Note that the text encoder used are different in both the nodes. Link to the text encoder is given above, and these are for the GGUF text encoders. I'm using this right now with the new nodes. You can use this if you have a smaller graphics card. And below is the text encoder, used with the older nodes. This is the number of steps, which is the total of both the case samplers. And both the case sampler will process 3 steps for generation, which is the ending step for the first node and starting step for the second node. The second node is capped by the total number of 6 steps, so it won't go further. The output, which is in the latent space, gets decoded into pixel space by the VAE, and then we see the result. These nodes are to upscale the video, and we'll see this later. The video generated by both the case samplers is based on a few conditions. And these are the conditions: image embed and text embed. Text embeds are the text prompt given here. And the image embeds condition is the 4 images uploaded above. This image was generated using the Quinn edit model. And the size of the image is being adjusted here. The same size is connected to all the resize nodes. Out of these 4 images, the first and last images goes to the start and end frame node. And then the mask for 81 frames is generated, Next is a replace image in batch node, which should replace the image from the batch of 81 frames. In this case, I am replacing the 28th frame with the given image. To check, you can bypass the case samplers and run the workflow. In my case, the second image, which is in the 28th position, should be visible at the 29th position. So, adjust the images accordingly with the help of the replace node. For the third image, I am again using the replace image in batch node to replace the frame at position 52. So, make sure to adjust the images to the best possible position based on the difference in the character. You can also do this with three images by bypassing this node. All the frames with the condition set by the uploaded images goes to the case sampler. And these are pixel images which are encoded using VAE, which is then used in the latent space for video generation. The links to the VAE are given, and the one I am using can be downloaded from here. So that was the workflow. You can upload the image. I was using the Quinn model to generate different variations of the character. I have made a video on generating multiple images. The link will be in the description. So after uploading the image, check once and then activate the case sampler to process the video generation. It took 26 seconds for one step, which was around 200 seconds, to generate 81 frames on my 4060 Ti 16GB. And this is the result. This is a simple upscale node using the ESR GAN model. Link to download the model is given. This node generates the 16 FPS upscale video. And this is for extra frames. The video output here is a 32 FPS upscale video. The 32 FPS will be a lot smoother than the previous one. The seed ID in the case sampler is fixed, so once you get a decent result, activate this upscale node to upscale the video for final use. So that is it in this video. I hope you have an excellent day.